बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अहमद मुमताज़ मुस्तहसन, योर टीचर फॉर CSE 141 इंट्रोडक्शन टू कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर आई डेमोंस्ट्रेटेड यू टू सेट अप अ विजुअल सी एनवायरनमेंट ऑन योर पर्सनल कंप्यूटर्स और वेयर यू आर सपोज टू टेक अप द हैंड्स ऑन एक्सरसाइजेस। वी स्टार्टेड with the demonstration and at the end of the demonstration I also explained you how you can execute your program in this environment. I have not explained the program in detail, so today I will start with the explanation of that program. Okay, this was the program that you copy from your slides, and I instructed you to place it in the environment, and then remember you compile it and link it and executed it. But we done all these three steps in the by using simple command called the build command. In this program, the first two statements hash sign include iostream and hash sign include CONIO card console.io.h, which is a header file. So I did not explain, and I promised to explain it in the next lecture. So today I would like to explain this, which we called last time as a preprocessor directives or preprocessing directives. So preprocessing directives performed by the program called preprocessor. This preprocessor modifies the source code in the RAM according to the directive, according to the preprocessor directive. And these preprocessor directives has preprocessing commands which are embedded in the source code. This preprocessor by default removes all the white spaces. Do you remember what are the white spaces? White spaces we called space, tab, carriage return, that we use to explain, use to make the program more prominent, more readable, and to make it more attractive, you can say. So this preprocessor directives removes all the white spaces. The modification carried out by the preprocessor directive does not save the output onto the disk. So it performs whatever it is supposed to do, some action item which are to be taken by default and some which are instructed through preprocessing commands. But it does not save the output onto the disk, rather it passes on the output of the preprocessing to the compiler. So your source code, which is saved on the disk, remains unchanged. A quick revision of the compilation. Compilation is done by a program called compiler that translates your source code into an object code. An object code is called machine code. It checks the syntax according to the language. As I explained you last time, that you have got a compiler for each language. So you can have a compiler of C language, you can have a compiler of C++ language, or you may have a compiler of Fortran language. So it checks the syntax according to the syntax of that particular language. It saves the object code onto the disk, provided there are no errors or you have instructed it to save the object code. The object code file can even be generated if the compiler generates some warning messages for you. लेकिन अगर compiler कोई error message generate करेगा तो object code जो है वो disk पर save नहीं होगा. However, अगर warning messages होंगे तो still अगर आपकी instruction है कि object code को save किया जाए तो ये object code को save करेगा. Or by default, it will save the object code so that the next program, which is called the linker, should be able to use it. This object code is basically operating system dependent. Means, ke object code for every different hardware might be different. Similarly, object code for different platform means operating system is different. So if you have a Linux or Windows operating system, then the object code compiled by the operating system will not be executed other than some other operating system. But still, you can learn to generate an object code which is machine independent or which could be a platform independent. But this will do, or this we will learn maybe at the end of this particular course. Linking. Last time we said that the linker, which is a program that converts the object code to an executable code. So the linker basically combines the library files, supporting object code, which are provided into the libraries, or you may combine your different object code and you would like to produce one single executable code. So the object code files can come from the runtime libraries or other libraries that you might have created by yourself, or the object files that you have created. And the result of the linker program is saved onto the disk, so that next time or in future, if you want to execute the program, you are not supposed to go through all the phases of compilation and linking. So, whenever you have got an executable code, you can run it as many times as you like. Like the object code, the linker does not generate an executable code if there are some linking errors. अब ये linking error किस किस्म के हो सकते हैं? Obviously, मैंने आपको बताया था कि linker जो है वो address translation करता है. मेमोरी की ट्रांसलेशन करता है, मेमोरी की लोकेशन की ट्रांसलेशन करता है, मैप करता है प्रोग्राम के एक पार्ट को दूसरे पार्ट के साथ. सो इफ समथिंग इज मिसिंग, सम लाइब्रेरी फंक्शंस आर मिसिंग, सम डेफिनेशंस आर मिसिंग, देन इट विल जनरेट सम एरर मैसेजेस. एंड इफ देर आर सम एरर मैसेजेस, देन देर इज नो यूज ऑफ जनरेटिंग द एग्जीक्यूटेबल कोड, बिकॉज यू वोंट बी एबल टू एग्जीक्यूट इट प्रॉपरली. Therefore, if there are certain error messages, then the linker does not generate any executable. So, dear students, now you should know what an editor does. Kya karta hai editor? It produces the source file. आप एडिट करते हैं, टाइप करते हैं, अपने एल्गोरिदम को कन्वर्ट करते हैं लैंग्वेज के अंदर. देन यू यूज द एडिटर टू की इन योर प्रोग्राम इनटू द एनवायरनमेंट, सो दैट यू कैन प्रोड्यूस द ऑब्जेक्ट कोड, एग्जीक्यूटेबल कोड. प्री प्रोसेसर मॉडिफाइज द सोर्स कोड. बट डज नॉट सेव इट ऑन टू द डिस्क, क्योंकि वो आपके लिए यूजफुल नहीं है. कंपाइलर कन्वर्ट्स द ऑब्जेक्ट कोड इन टू द मशीन कोड, सॉरी द कंपाइलर कन्वर्ट्स द सोर्स कोड इन टू द ऑब्जेक्ट कोड. ठीक है, होता तो ये मशीन कोड ही है, लेकिन ये अभी आप उसको एग्जीक्यूट नहीं कर सकते. तो आउटपुट जो है कंपाइलर की इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट कोड और ऑब्जेक्ट फाइल. लिंकर की इनपुट क्या है? ऑब्जेक्ट फाइल. आउटपुट क्या है? एग्जीक्यूटेबल कोड. कंपाइलर की इनपुट क्या है? सोर्स फाइल. और आउटपुट क्या है? ऑब्जेक्ट फाइल. सो आई होप यू हैव नाउ अंडरस्टूड व्हाट आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ एन एडिटर, प्रीप्रोसेसर, कंपाइलर एंड लिंकर. सो लास्ट टाइम मैंने आपको एक्सप्लेन नहीं किया था द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द सी प्रोग्राम. बड़ी क्विकली उसको पास ऑन कर दिया था बिकॉज द पर्पज वॉज जस्ट टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट यू हाउ कैन यू एग्जीक्यूट योर फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम. नाउ इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ दिस लेक्चर आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द सी प्रोग्राम. टॉप पे तो आपने देखा हैश साइन इंक्लूड आईओ स्ट्रीम, ये तो प्री प्रोसेसर डायरेक्टिव हो गए. यूजिंग नेम स्पेस, ये भी आपका प्री प्रोसेसर डायरेक्टिव हो गया. सो वी स्टार्ट विद ए प्रोग्राम कॉल्ड वॉइड मेन. एफडीसी प्रोग्राम कंसिस्ट ऑफ फंक्शंस, वन और मोर फंक्शंस, बहुत ज्यादा फंक्शंस भी हो सकते हैं, एक अकेला फंक्शन भी हो सकता है, बट वन फंक्शन विच इज मैंडेटरी and has got a default name is called main. Main ek default function hai and it is mandatory. Why it is mandatory? Because the operating system transfers the control from the operating system to your main function. Is main function ke saath, if you see in the beginning, we have used a keyword called void. Do you remember what is void? Void is a data type, which means nothing. Every function in C language is supposed to return something, supposed to return some data, or supposed to return some output. But there could be a function, they may not return anything. Ab main ko control mila hai operating system se. अब ये मेन ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम को कुछ रिटर्न नहीं कर रहा. सो जब ये कुछ रिटर्न नहीं कर रहा तो ये क्या रिटर्न कर रहा है? इट इज रिटर्निंग नथिंग. और एक स्पेशल डेटा टाइप है जिसको हम कहते हैं नथिंग, उसका नाम है वॉइड. सो वॉइड मेन मींस द मेन फंक्शन इज नॉट रिटर्निंग एनीथिंग टू द प्रोग्राम विच हैज कॉल्ड दिस फंक्शन. और इस फंक्शन को किसने कॉल किया? ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ने कॉल किया. प्रोग्राम के अंदर वी हैव गॉट वन स्टेटमेंट सी आउट, हेलो वर्ल्ड, टर्मिनेटेड बाय सेमी कॉलन. ये जो सी आउट है दिस इज कार्डन स्टेटमेंट. एवरी स्टेटमेंट इन ए सी प्रोग्राम मस्ट बी टर्मिनेटेड बाय अ सेमी कॉलन. याद रहेगा, A statement in C is terminated by semicolon. ये mandatory है. Next, ये brackets क्या है? Curly brackets, braces. इनको कहते हैं delimiters. आपको पता है कि curly bracket, opening curly bracket and closing curly bracket. So opening and closing braces or curly brackets mark the start and end of a code. अब यहां पे code क्या है आपका? Main function है. तो curly bracket mark कर रही है start of the code और दूसरी curly bracket mark कर रही है end of the code. ये कर्ली ब्रैकेट्स हम यूज करेंगे डिफरेंट ब्लॉक्स के अंदर भी. और ब्लॉक कौन कौन से हो सकते हैं? ब्लॉक्स कुड बी योर इफ स्टेटमेंट ब्लॉक हो सकता है, फॉर लूप का ब्लॉक हो सकता है, और देयर कुड बी फ्यू मोर ब्लॉक्स. स्विच स्टेटमेंट का ब्लॉक हो सकता है. We will discuss it in detail when we will reach to these topics. So we are discussing the syntax. एक टर्म यूज करते हैं सी के अंदर जिसको कहते हैं वाइट स्पेस. अभी चंद मिनट पहले प्री प्रोसेसर के डायरेक्टिव्स में मैंने ये टर्मिनोलॉजी यूज की थी. वाइट स्पेस मैंने आपको बताया था क्या होता है. वाइट स्पेस कुड बी अ स्पेस, कुड बी अ टैब, कुड बी अ कैरिज रिटर्न, could be a new line. C pays no attention to the white space characters encountered in a program. यही वजह है कि प्रीप्रोसेसर जो है वो सारे के सारे white spaces को remove कर देता है. So you can put as many white spaces as you want. तो उसका purpose क्या हुआ? Purpose मैंने आपको पहले भी बताया था कि ये प्रोग्राम की रीडेबिलिटी को इंप्रूव करता है. ओके, सो आप देख सकते हैं कि यहां पर कैरिज रिटर्न यूज हुआ है. देन ये दिस इज द कैरिज रिटर्न, दिस इज बेसिकली द स्पेस न्यू लाइन. यहां पे भी हमने यूज किए मल्टीपल ऑफ न्यू लाइंस. सो यू कैन यूज इट जस्ट टू इंक्रीज द रीडेबिलिटी ऑफ योर प्रोग्राम. नेक्स्ट इज इंडेंटेशन. यू कैन स्ट्रेच योर प्रोग्राम वर्टिकली एज मच एज यू लाइक बाय पुटिंग न्यू लाइंस एंड कैरी रिटर्न्स कैरेक्टर्स. दैट विल मेक योर कोड more readable. So indentation, blocks of code and closing braces ya brackets ya curly brackets is an important aspect of making the program more readable. Ab yahi program hai, if you see it at the end, ab sare white spaces nikal de, so your program will look like this. Okay, so above program and this program has one and the same impact, dono ek hi tarah execute honge. Okay, so we have discussed some basic syntax of the C language. Let us take up the next topic, which is the variable names. हमने इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट के अंदर वेरिएबल्स को डिफाइन करने की कोशिश की थी और मैंने आपको बताया था नेम असाइन टू मेमोरी लोकेशन. किसी भी मेमोरी लोकेशन को आप कोई भी नाम असाइन कर सकते हैं, उसको हम कहते हैं वेरिएबल नेम्स. दीज आर लाइक कंटेनर्स. अब मेमोरी लोकेशन क्या है? मेमोरी लोकेशन इज एन एरिया where you put in certain data, where you can store certain data that you may like to retrieve it. Retrieve kise kehte hain? To read out the data, dobara us data ko padhne ko retrieve kehte hain. So you can store values in memory locations, you can modify them as and when required. So name of the memory locations, name assigned to the memory locations are called variable names. अब वेरिएबल नेम जो है इट हैज गॉट सर्टन वैल्यू. वो जो आप डेटा वेरिएबल के अंदर रखते हैं उसको कहते हैं वैल्यू ऑफ द वेरिएबल. जब आपने किसी वेरिएबल में डेटा रखना है, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू पुट सर्टन डेटा आइटम्स इन टू द वेरिएबल, यू पुट the variable on left side, then you use an assignment operator which is equal, and then you put the data on the right side of that particular statement. So the left side of that statement is the L value. Okay. So L values are the values that can be on the left side of an assignment statement. So when we do an assignment statement, the left side of the assignment operator must be an L value, जो आपने उसको वैल्यू असाइन की है. R वैल्यू क्या है, जो के राइट साइड के ऊपर है, जो के आप असाइन करते हैं L वैल्यू को. सो हम कहते हैं कि एन R वैल्यू रेफर्स टू एनी वैल्यू डेट कैन बी असाइन टू एन L वैल्यू. लेफ्ट साइड को जो आप असाइन करते हैं वो वैल्यू होती है जो आपने राइट साइड के ऊपर लिखी होती है. एग्जाम्पल्स 7, यू कैन से एक्स इज इक्वल टू 7, सो 7 इज असाइन टू एक्स. जो एक्स की प्रीवियस वैल्यू है वो खत्म हो जाएगी और उसको न्यू वैल्यू असाइन हो जाएगी विच इज 7. यू कैन असाइन एन एक्सप्रेशन टू द वेरिएबल. आप कह सकते हैं y इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस 5. तो x के जो प्रीवियस कॉन्टेंट्स हैं उसमें इट विल एड 5. आफ्टर एडिंग 5 द रिजल्ट, सपोज द प्रीवियस कॉन्टेंट्स वर 2 एंड यू सेड x प्लस 5, द एक्सप्रेशन विल बी एवेल्युएटेड टू 7. सो यू विल असाइन 7 टू द वेरिएबल विच इज placed on the left side of the assignment operator. I will give you few examples also. Can we say 3 is equal to 5? Mathematically bhi nahi keh sakte aur C language mein bhi nahi keh sakte. It is incorrect. Can we say x plus 1 is equal to y plus 2? No, ye bhi nahi keh sakte. Why? I just said के left side पे you can only put the variable name. X plus 1 is an expression, so you cannot equate two expressions. क्योंकि ये एक assignment operator के through आप इसको use कर रहे हैं. तो R value जो है वो y plus 2 है, you cannot assign it to x plus 1. Similarly, x plus 5 is an expression, you cannot assign any variable content to an expression. Ha! Z is equal to y plus 4. This is correct. Kyun? Kyunki R value jo hai, that is an expression, y plus 4, which you can assign to a variable, L value, and L value is a variable which is Z, so this is a correct assignment. When L value has assigned a R value, the current L value is overwritten. इससे पहले Z में जो कुछ भी लिखा हुआ था वो खत्म हो जाएगा. A new contents will be loaded into the variable Z. Variable names को हम C language में use करते हैं terminology which is called identifiers. So variable names are identifiers. तो क्या सारे identifiers variable names हैं? नहीं. All the identifiers are not variable names. इसका मतलब है कुछ और चीजें भी हैं जिनको हम identifiers कह सकते हैं. Such as variable तो है ही हैं identifiers. Data types are also special variables जिनको identifiers कहते हैं. Constants, name assigned to the constants are identifiers. Name given to our functions are called identifiers. We said variable names are identifiers. Ab hum identifiers ko define karte hain. Identifier can be defined as ya can be defined using letters, numbers and underscore. So any combination of letters, numbers and underscore we can use to define any identifier. These identifiers are case sensitive. So agar aap likhte hain sum with lower case, it is different variable name as sum where s is written in the upper case. Similarly, if you use all three characters in uppercase SUM, it will be another variable name. So SUM, next SUM, and next SUM will be considered as three different variable names or three different identifiers in C language. You cannot name any identifier starting with a digit. So first name, where I have used one ST name, I read it out as first name, is an illegal identifier because it is starting with a digit. Whereas the next one, divided by 10, here I have used two digits, 1 and 0, but this is legal because it is not starting with any digit. We can use a variable name that may start with underscore, but it is considered not a good practice because most of the variables that are used in the libraries, in the system calls, in the operating systems, to distinguish between the system defined variables and user defined variable, the system uses the underscore as the starting name of the identifier. So underscore valid system call, although it is legal, but we don't consider it as a good practice. Okay. You can define a variable name with any length, but only the first 32 characters determines the uniqueness of your variable. So I've used a really long name, more than 31 characters and characters. I've used two variable names which are slightly different but will be considered as the same variable name. Kyun? Kyunki first 32 characters jo hai, they are the same. Similarly, you cannot use a space or a special character in your variable name. So gross space salary is considered as illegal because it contains a space. Percentage rate is considered as illegal because we have used a special percentage character in the identifier name. Similarly, we should not use the keywords or the reserve words. We use some words to define certain information, certain data types, something in the compiler. So whatever words the compiler has already used are predefined words called keywords, and they have predefined meanings. So you cannot change the meanings of the identifiers or the keywords that the compiler has defined by itself. So I'll give you some keywords in this table. These are the keywords that has special meaning in C. You can add few more to complete the list in C++. This list is basically for the C. If you are confused with C and C++, I promise to explain you very shortly. So the identifiers could be the data types also. In C, we have 5 different data types. Integer, declared as int. So the compiler has defined integer data type by using a word int. This int has become a keyword or a reserve word for the compiler that is used to define a data type called integer. So all the data types which are written here, float, double, character, void, these are defined using the keywords called reservoirs. Float defines a float data type. What is float data type? Float data type is a number containing a decimal point. Similarly, double, the same, but they have a slightly difference used by the compiler. So I will explain the difference between float and double in the next slide. Then we can use character with the keyword char, char. There is no data type that can be used as a string. So we will use this char, and I'll explain you later on, maybe somewhere in 12th or 13th lecture, where we will use these strings. But at this stage, it's sufficient hai aapke liye ki you should know how can we define a character using char keyword. Void defines nothing, but it's very important because there would be some functions that will not be returning anything, and we will call those function as void function. Size and type of the data types. With the development of the computers, with the development of the hardwares, more recently you are getting the computers which are more powerful. So the definition of int, long, short also change. So we can say that int is a data type that is used to store integer data. Integer numbers, a number that does not contain any decimal point, int. So size of int is at least 16 bit, or commonly could be 32 bit. Long ek zyada se data type nahi hai, but we'll use it as a modifier of int, and we will use it in combination with int to define a data type having double capacity. तो अगर आपका int 16 का है तो long int 32 bits का हो जाएगा, और अगर आपका int 32 bit का है तो long int 64 bit का हो जाएगा. Short at least 8 bit. You can define signed and unsigned integers also by using the keyword unsigned. By default, the keywords are considered as integers are considered as signed integers. But agar aap categorically unsigned integers use karna chahte hain, then you can use the keyword called unsigned. So you can define unsigned int. That will tell the compiler that the next identifier which is going to be defined should have a data type integer which is unsigned, should be considered as unsigned integer. The negative numbers are stored in 2's complement. Once again, a concept that should be discussed as a concept of the computer concept, fundamentals of computer concept. So once again, I promise you to explain it maybe separately in some other lecture. Float. Size is 32 bit. Contains decimal point. 1 to 5.123456 7. So you can have an accuracy up to 7 decimal places for a float which has a size of 32 bit. Double. When we say double, the precision is doubled. Ab decimal places ki jo accuracy hai, that will be up to 15 decimal places. With float, you can have a precision up to 7 decimal places. But With double, you can have a precision up to 15 decimal places. So it doubles the precision of a float. So quickly, we have defined a data type integer, float, double, character, and void. So let us talk about character. You can define a character in an 8-bit character size. There are different codes which are used to define a character. Most commonly on your PC, it is ANSI, ANSCII, American National Standard Code for Information Interchange, or Interchange Information. American National Standard Code for Interchange Information, or Information Interchange. IBM machines used to have their own code. They called it as EBCDIC code, Extended Binary Coded Decimal Interchange Code. It was also 8-bit code. Now we have got another code which is called Unicode. Iski bhi kya reason hai? Fundamentals of computer concepts mein main aapko explain karunga ki hame Unicode ki zarurat kyun pesh aayi. Void, size of the void is zero because it is nothing. It is just used to indicate that it does not contain any data, any information. So we have defined five different data types: integer, used to store, process integer data; float and double, used to process real data. Real means a data, a number that contains a decimal point. Character is used to store character data. So at this time, we have only defined the data type that is used to represent one single character. But as I said, we will discuss the modification of this char data type to represent the string also. A string is a combination of multiple characters. Finally, the void. Fifth data type is void. And we have already defined that void represents nothing, but it's very important to have this data type to define the functions. Size of the data type. I think I have already confused you in the previous slide by saying ke integer 16 bit ka bhi ho sakta hai, integer 32 bit ka bhi ho sakta hai. So how can you overcome this confusion? Ye ek natural data types hai jo 16 bit or 32 bit ka bhi ho sakta hai, depending upon your machine. So if you want to see what is the word size or what is the integer size of your machine, you can use a built-in function of C language, which is size of. So you can say printf function, in which you can use this. I will also explain what is printf later on. So ek function aapke paas maujood hai C language mein, jisko aap use kar sakte hain to find out what is the size of int, float, double, character, of default size of your compiler on the machine, on your hardware. Okay, ye panch to the predefined data types. In addition to data types, there are some more concepts. These are like constants, but these are constants, literal constants and symbols are directives to the preprocessor. Literal kya cheez hai? Unnamed constraints that appear literally in source code. For example, 385. You have used 385 as a constant. So this 385 is guarded as a literal. Constants. You can assign a name to a constant. 385 को आप कोई नाम भी दे सकते हैं. तो जो नाम आप 385 को देंगे, that is called a name. But this name is different from the variable name. It is just like variable name, but you cannot change the contents of this constant. So you will use a keyword const, C-O-N-S-T, before the data type. I'll give you the example in the next slide. Similarly, you can give a name to a constant through a preprocessor directives called define. So you can define means you can define any name to any numeric literals using define preprocessor directive. So the value remains the same. So these are the examples. Literally 125, you can use it as a constant in your program. You can use S, backslash T is a character. I will explain you, it is a special character which I will explain later on. Similarly, you can define any hexadecimal character by the backslash XC. C is a hexadecimal character. C means 12. A is 10. B is 11. C is 12. D is 13. E is 14. F is 15. So this C means 12 is a hexadecimal character. You can use floating point 6.023, or you can use 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. You might remember this is a special number. You can also use 5e to the power 12. This is another notation, 5.0 into 10 to the power 12. So you can assign these literals as a name through using const keyword or by using the define keywords. So what the preprocessor directive does, preprocessor directives replace, for example, here we have used define radius 15.0. So we have defined a name to a constant और हमने इसका नाम रखा radius. Since we have defined it using define directive, so it is called a symbol. We have defined a constant using data type double pi, and we have used a word const before the data type, so this is called a constant. आपने कांस्टेंट का नाम रखा पाई, विच इज इक्वल टू 3.14159. वेयरएज 3.14159 इज ए लिटरल, क्योंकि आप एक न्यूमेरिक वैल्यू डायरेक्टली यूज कर रहे हैं. नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन इन द प्रोग्राम, वेयर एवर वी हैव यूज्ड अ सिंबल और अ कांस्टेंट, द प्री प्रोसेसर डायरेक्टिव विल रिप्लेस द सिंबल विद इट्स वैल्यू. तो जहां पे रेडियस लिखा हुआ होगा, प्री प्रोसेसर उसकी जगह पर 15.0 लिख देगा, और जहां पे पाई लिखा हुआ होगा वहां पे 3.14159 से रिप्लेस कर देगा. तो अगर प्री प्रोसेसर ने इसको रिप्लेस करना है तो व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग इट? द आंसर इज वेरी सिंपल, वी आर यूजिंग इट टू मेक द प्रोग्राम मोर रीडेबल. जब आपका सोर्स कोड कोई रीड आउट करेगा, वो क्विकली उसे पता चल जाएगा कि यू आर यूजिंग 15.0 एज ए रेडियस, And you are computing the circumference by using the formula 2 pi r and area by pi r square. So it makes the program more readable. Okay. Next, any operator has a function. We have assigned some function to each and every operator. Plus kya karta hai? Add karta hai. Minus subtract karta hai. Multiplication operator multiply karta hai aur divide operator jo hai wo divide karta hai. Then we assign the precedence also. Precedence kya hai? Ki in which order this operator should be executed. अब अगर हम देखें a मल्टीप्लाई बाय b प्लस c मल्टीप्लाई बाय d व्हाट इट विल डू इट विल मल्टीप्लाई a एंड b फर्स्ट देन इट विल मल्टीप्लाई c एंड d एंड देन इट विल ऐड द रिजल्ट सो इसने ये क्यों नहीं किया a और b को मल्टीप्लाई करके c में ऐड किया जो आंसर आ जाए उसको d से मल्टीप्लाई कर दे नो no. It will not do like that because multiplication has higher precedence over plus. So, jis operator ki precedence high hogi relative to the other operator used in the expression, wo operators jo hain pehle execute honge. So, in this example, a multiplied by b mein, a multiplied by b. Will be executed first, then it will not add C, rather it will multiply C multiply by D because there is a competition between this multiplication, sorry, this operator plus and this multiplication. Ye to multiply ho gaya na, A multiply by B. Ab प्लस पहले होना है या मल्टीप्लाई पहले होना है सिंस मल्टीप्लीकेशन हैज अ हायर प्रेसिडेंस ओवर प्लस सो सी मल्टीप्लाई बाय डी विल टेक्स प्लेस फर्स्ट एंड देन द रिजल्ट ए मल्टीप्लाई बाय बी का रिजल्ट जो है सी मल्टीप्लाई बाय डी वाले रिजल्ट के साथ ऐड हो जाएगा ओके एक तीसरी चीज भी होती है ऑपरेटर्स के लिए जिसको कहते हैं एसोसिएटिविटी एसोसिएटिविटी एसोसिएशन क्या है उसकी ये एसोसिएशन लेफ्ट से राइट जाती है या राइट से लेफ्ट जाती है माइनस बी जो है ये ए के लिए है या माइनस बी जो है माइनस जो है वो बी के लिए है या माइनस ए के लिए है ऑब्वियसली मैंने ऑलरेडी जवाब आपको बता दिया कि इट इज फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट So minus b, minus is for b, minus c is for c. So the order in which the operators of the same precedence combined. Same precedence aapko samajh mein aayega when I will take few examples. So we have talked about three things with the operator. Go back through previous slide. One is called function, second is called precedence, and third is called associativity. So you have to remember that every operator should have its prime function, then it should have some precedence level, then it should have some associativity. Okay? Coming back to our assignment operator. याद है वी हैव यूज्ड एल वैल्यू व्हिच इज इक्वल टू आर वैल्यू सो इट इवैल्यूएट्स राइट हैंड साइड एक्स प्लस फाइव कॉल्ड आर वैल्यू व्हिच इज सेट टू इक्वल टू एल वैल्यू सो द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज द वेरिएबल व्हिच इज इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड या राइट हैंड साइड डेटा इज असाइन टू द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड So, इसकी एसोसिएटिविटी क्या हुई फ्रॉम राइट टू लेफ्ट डू रिमेंबर वी हैव असाइंड सर्टन एक्सप्रेशंस अरिथमेटिक एक्सप्रेशंस अब अरिथमेटिक एक्सप्रेशंस की बजाय वी कुड लाइक टू यूज इट विद मल्टीपल वेरिएबल्स. वाई इज इक्वल टू एक्स इज इक्वल टू फाइव. वही किस सीक्वेंस में चले? राइट टू लेफ्ट. क्योंकि असाइनमेंट ऑपरेटर की एसोसिएटिविटी है फ्रॉम राइट टू लेफ्ट. सो फर्स्ट द फाइन फाइव विल बी असाइन टू एक्स. सो एक्स विल हैव फाइव. देन एक्स इज असाइन टू वाई. सो द वाई विल हैव अ वैल्यू इक्वल टू फाइव. सो फ्रॉम राइट टू लेफ्ट इज द एसोसिएटिविटी. सो आई विल समराइज हियर. वी हैव अ मल्टीप्लाई x multiplied by y, x multiplied by y. Association is from left to right. x को y से multiply करना है आपने. x divided by y, left to right. x, ये percentage y, it has got a special meaning that I will explain it to you later on. इसको हम कहते हैं modulo, modulus या modulo. बेसिकली इट इज यूज टू पिक अप द रिमाइंडर. जब हम x को y से डिवाइड करते हैं तो वी गेट द कोशेंट. और अगर हम कोशेंट की बजाय रिमाइंडर में इंटरेस्टेड हों तो हम डिवाइड की जगह पर ये परसेंटेज सिंबल यूज करते हैं. सो मल्टीप्लीकेशन, डिविजन एंड परसेंटेज हैव द सेम प्रेसिडेंस लेवल. So whenever there is a competition between the operators having the same precedence level, to prevail kya karega? Who will be the winner? The winner will be whichever comes first from left to right. Okay? Whichever comes from left to right, that is the precedence. So A multiplied by B multiplied by C, पहले क्या होगा? पहले A multiplied by B होगा और फिर B multiplied by C होगा. अगर हम कहें A multiplied by B divided by C, अब multiplication and division जो है दोनों एक level के operators हैं, तो winner कौन सा होगा, multiplication या division? The winner will be the one that comes first from left to right. So A multiplied by B divided by C may multiplication comes first before division. So पहले A और B को multiply करेंगे, जो answer आएगा उसको divide करेंगे C से. This is called precedence. Similarly, plus and minus have the same precedence. And again, if there is a competition, the winner will be whichever comes first from left to right. Addition, subtraction and multiplication works. You already know that. How do they work? Division ko thoda sa revise kar lete hain. The division operator returns the whole part of the division. Whole part kise kehte hain? Quotient ko. So, अगर हम कहें 12 डिवाइड बाय 3, द क्वेश्चन इज 4. सो अगर हम 12 डिवाइड बाय 3 करेंगे द आंसर विल बी 4. इफ वी डिवाइड 15 बाय 2 द आंसर इज 7. क्योंकि द क्वेश्चन इज 7. सो लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द मॉडुलस. Percent returns the remainder. 12 divided by 3 में आंसर आया था 4 because 4 was the quotient. 12 modulo 3 आंसर is 0 क्योंकि remainder is 0. तो इसका जो आंसर आएगा expression का वो आएगा 0. 15 modulo 2 the answer is 1 क्योंकि इसका integer remainder जो बचेगा वो 1 होगा. So with modulo we can pick up the remainder, with slash we can pick up the quotient. Quickly take one example. 2 plus 3 multiplied by 4. Ab answer kya aana chahiye? 2 plus 3 is 5, 5 multiplied by 4 answer is 20. No, Why? Because 2 plus 3 multiplied by 4 contains two operators. Here, the precedence of multiplication is higher than plus. It means 3 multiplied by 4 will be calculated first and then the answer will be added with 2. So the answer is equal to 14. लेकिन if you want कि 2 plus 3 पहले add हो फिर से you multiply it by 4. You want के 2 और 3 को add करें पहले और answer जो है उसको 4 से multiply करें. Yes, you can do that. कैसे? आपको यहाँ पर parenthesis use करनी पड़ेंगी. So you will use the parenthesis. Within bracket you will put 2 plus 3 then multiply by 4. Now parentheses have got the highest precedence. Pehle parentheses ko solve kar dega system jo hai. So 2 plus 3 add ho jayenge. Ab isko 4 se multiply karenge to answer will be 20. So you can use parentheses to overrule the precedence of the operator. Kuch cheezein aur bhi hain. Some more concepts that you must know. When you mix up integer with double, ab integer ka size suppose 16 bit or double ka size suppose 32 bit, you multiply an integer x, yeah, you add 4.3 to x where x is an integer. ऐसी सूरत में सिस्टम प्रमोट्स द लोअर डेटा टाइप टू द लॉन्गर डेटा टाइप. ठीक. सो एक्स विल बी प्रमोटेड टू डबल एंड द रिजल्ट विल बी अ डबल मींस एक्स प्लस 4.3 का जो आंसर आएगा दैट इज नॉट इंटीजर बट दैट विल बी अ डबल. हाउ कैन यू पिक इट अप? वी विल डिस्कस इट लेटर ऑन. But at this stage, you should know that whenever you mix up two data types, one is lower in size, one is higher in size, then the system automatically promotes one to the other. Integer division. When you divide x with 3 and x is an integer, answer kya aana chahiye? 1.66. Suppose if x is equal to 5, or you divide 5 by 3, the answer should be 1.66. But if your x is an integer, then the answer is not 1.66 because 1.66 is not an integer value. So yahan pe kya hoga? The fraction part will be dropped. And your result, because you are dividing x with 3, so basically the system will pick up integer division. So integer division ka answer integer mein aana chahiye. Okay, so the answer will be equal to kya answer aayega? 1, not 1.66. I have already explained you that you can use parentheses to force different order of evaluation. Agar aap order of evaluation change karna chahte hain, jaisa ki humne pichhvi slide mein kiya tha, 2 plus 3 mein parentheses use kar bhi thi. Multiplied by 4. Similarly, हम अगर 12 में से 5 minus करना चाहते हैं पहले, so 12 minus 5 is 7, multiplied by 4 is 14, so we have used the parenthesis here. Arithmetic operator precedence. Precedence rules specify the order in which operators are evaluated. Associativity determines whether it is from left to right or from right to left. So it determines the order in which the operator is associated with the data type. In order to remember, for arithmetic operators, people use a term PMDAS. PMDAS. This, agar ye sari situation ho, to precedence kya hoga? Parenthesis, then multiplication, then division, then addition, then subtraction. लेकिन बी केयरफुल, डिवीजन एंड मल्टीप्लीकेशन में विच एवर कम्स फर्स्ट फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट, क्योंकि यहाँ पे मल्टीप्लीकेशन लेफ्ट पे है, डिवीजन राइट पे है, लिहाजा हम से कहेंगे पहले पैरेंथिसिस, देन मल्टीप्लीकेशन, देन डिवीजन। एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्ट, ए एस, एडिशन पहले है, सब्ट्रैक्शन बाद में है, देयरफॉर द प्रेसिडेंस इज एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन। सो पी एम डास, दिस इज अ टर्मिनोलॉजी पीपल यूज इट टू रिमेंबर द ऑर्डर, टू रिमेंबर द सीक्वेंस। देर आर फ्यू मोर ऑपरेटर्स विच आर कॉल्ड bitwise operators, not, shift left, shift right, bitwise AND, exclusive OR, that I will teach you in future. So we just take it on few more operators, but before that I would like to caution you to be very careful between equality operator and assignment operator. Most of the time the students are confused with the assignment operator and equality operator. So I would like to explain you with the help of an example. X is equal to 5, Y is equal to 7. If X equal 5, printf will not be printed. If x equal y, then printf x is equal to y and y is equal to percentage d. I will explain you later on this printf function. It's new for you, but here I just would like to give you a caution regarding this operator which is called an equality operator, and this operator that we have already discussed as a assignment operator. The first operator compares x with y, and this is called a relational operator that we will discuss later on, whereas x equal y is an assignment operator which assigns the value of y to x. The value of y is assigned to x, then it is a non-zero value. It's mean non-zero value is considered as equal to true. So the second part of the printf will be executed. The first printf statement will not be executed. The second printf statement will be executed. So please, you have to be just to give you a caution between equality and assignment operator. I have used this slide, but if you are unable to understand this particular concept, don't worry, I will explain you later on after I discuss the other very important operators. With the assignment operator, we can use some more operators which are special operator, plus plus and minus minus, increment and decrement operators. The value of the variable before and after is used in the expression is incremented or decremented. For example, when we use plus plus symbol, we can use it with x plus plus. Since x plus plus, the plus plus is after the variable, so we call it as increment after. In the next example, we have used x minus minus. This minus minus is after the variable, therefore it is called decrement after. What does it mean? The value of x, whatever the contents of the x are, will be used in the expression. And after using the expression, the contents of the variable will automatically be incremented. It's mean that we have combined two statements in one single statement. X ki value ko use karo, यूज़ करने के बाद इसको इंक्रीमेंट कर दो. इट इज़ कॉल्ड ऑटो इंक्रीमेंट, इंक्रीमेंट आफ्टर और डिक्रीमेंट आफ्टर, ऑटो डिक्रीमेंट और ऑटो इंक्रीमेंट. द सेम कॉन्सेप्ट वी कैन यूज इट एज प्लस प्लस एक्स और माइनस माइनस एक्स. हेयर द कॉन्टेंट्स आर इंक्रीमेंटेड फर्स्ट बिफोर यूजिंग इट इन द एक्सप्रेशन. माइनस माइनस एक्स, द कॉन्टेंट्स आर डिक्रीमेंटेड फर्स्ट बिफोर दे आर यूज इन द एक्सप्रेशन. तो फर्क समझ में आया आपका? आफ्टर मीन्स इंक्रीमेंट और डिक्रीमेंट. आफ्टर मीन्स इंक्रीमेंट और डिक्रीमेंट द कॉन्टेंट्स आफ्टर यूजिंग इट इन द एक्सप्रेशंस. इंक्रीमेंट बिफोर और डिक्रीमेंट बिफोर मीन्स अपडेट द कॉन्टेंट्स बिफोर यूजिंग इट इन टू द एक्सप्रेशंस. सो सिंस दे आर रिलेटेड टू द एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन, सो आई हैव डिसाइडेड टू डिस्कस इट एट दिस स्टेज. So let us take an example. Integer x, y is equal to x plus plus. As I said, as I have already promised that I will explain you the printf statement later on in the next lecture. Here the purpose is just to show you what will be the content of x and y. Ab statement number 2 mein अगर हम देखें y इज इक्वल टू प्लस प्लस, y इज इक्वल टू x प्लस प्लस, x की वैल्यू है 4, 4 विल बी असाइन टू y एंड देन द वैल्यू ऑफ x विल बी इंक्रीमेंटेड. जब हम इस स्टेटमेंट को यूज करेंगे टू प्रिंट द कॉन्टेंट्स ऑफ x एंड y, तो x के कॉन्टेंट्स विल बी इक्वल टू 5 और y के कॉन्टेंट्स विल बी इक्वल टू 4. क्यों? क्योंकि इस पर्टिकुलर स्टेटमेंट के अंदर x के कॉन्टेंट्स जो हैं वो हमने इंक्रीमेंट कर दिए हैं. वी सेड x प्लस प्लस 5, लेकिन ये हमने इंक्रीमेंट किया है आफ्टर असाइनिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ 4 टू y. इट इज इंक्रीमेंट आफ्टर. देयरफॉर व्हेन वी विल प्रिंट द वैल्यू ऑफ x एंड y, x की वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू 5 एंड y की वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू 4. Example 2, x is equal to 4, y is equal to plus plus x. Now, the content of x will be incremented first before assigning it to y. So, यहाँ पर पहले x के contents में एक increment होगा, एक add होगा, x के contents हो जाएंगे 5, then it will be assigned to y. So when we will print the contents of x and y, both will be printed as 5. इसी concept को we can extend with multiplication, division, modulo and some other operators that we will study later on. So we can say that instead of saying x is equal to x plus y, we can say that x plus equal y, which the system will read as x is equal to x plus y. Similarly, x minus equal y will be translated as x is equal to x minus y. X multiplied by equal y will be translated as x is equal to x multiplied by y. So the arithmetic operators and bitwise operator can be combined with assignment operators, but in a different way here. X divided by y, we can write down as x slash equal y will be translated as x divided by y. Okay, x modulo y, we can translate it, but we can use it as x modulo equal y. The remaining, since I have not taught you the bitwise operator, so I'll come back to these concepts later on. There is another very special operator which is called conditional operator. This conditional operator is a combination of question mark and colon. This is not semicolon, this is colon. Question mark and colon is interpreted as a single operator. Purpose is to perform conditional. So, example is x question mark y colon. Very interesting meaning. It will compare x with y. If x is non-zero, means it has some value, it is treated as a true, then the result of the expression will be equal to y. But if x is zero, means false, then the result of the expression will be equal to z. So, x question mark y colon z is treated as if x question mark y is true, then the output of expression is equal to y, otherwise the output of the expression will be equal to z. So we will also discuss it or repeat it in future when I will discuss some more operators called equality operators or relational operators. We have not discussed bitwise operators and we have not discussed the relational operators. We will discuss it in the next lecture. So, whatever we have discussed so far regarding the arithmetic operators, you can easily take up this quiz, which is a practice quiz. Solve the following expressions. 3 minus 8 divided by 4. 3 multiplied by 4 plus 18 divided by 2. So what is the answer of these arithmetic expressions? Let us solve this. First we'll solve A. 3 minus 8 divided by 4. There is a competition between minus and slash. And as you know, division operator, slash operator has higher precedence over minus. So 8 divided by 4 will be executed first. So 8 divided by 4 equals 2. Then you have 3 minus 2, the answer is equal to 1. Next, 3 multiplied by 4 plus 18 divided by 2. Now here you have got 1, 2, 3. You have got 1, multiplication, addition and division. So start solving it from left to right. 3 multiplied by 4 plus 18. So obviously multiplication has higher precedence over plus. So 3 multiplied by 4 will be evaluated first equal to 12. Next, should we add 12 with 18? Or should we perform 18 divided by 2 first? Since plus and slash, the winner is slash, has higher precedence over plus, so it will be executed first. So 18 divided by 2, the answer is 9. And then you can add 12 plus 9, the answer is 21. Okay. You can take up another quiz. Suppose A is equal to 2, B is equal to 4, C is equal to 6, and D is equal to 8. Then what should be the output of this expression? A multiplied by B plus C multiplied by D divided by 4. It will be solved as मैंने आपसे कहा था, you can use parenthesis. So first of all, it will perform the operation between A multiplied by B. So we have placed the bracket A multiplied by B. Then between plus and multiplication, it has got higher precedence. Then multiplication and division, they have got the same precedence level, but since multiplication comes first from left to right, so the winner is multiplication. So the next it will execute C multiply by D. Now we have got one operand A multiply by B, second we have got C multiply by D, then we have divide by 4. What should be the next? The competition is between plus and division. The division is the winner. So we will put the parenthesis here so that the division should be executed first. So 6 multiplied by 8 divided by 4, the answer is 12. Here the 2 multiplied by 4, the answer is 8. And finally, this plus will be executed. So this is another way to solve any arithmetic expression, that you start scanning the expression from left to right, put the parenthesis in the order where you consider that is the order of execution. So that will be an easy way to solve any arithmetic expression according to their precedence level. So I just give you another practice quiz. Here I've just used minus and plus. 5 minus 3 plus 4 plus 2 minus 1 plus 7. So all the operators have the same precedence level. Can we put the parenthesis to it? Yes. Since plus and minus have all the equal precedence, so this expression is evaluated from left to right. So just keep on putting the parenthesis. Pehle, sabse pehle execute hoga 5 minus 3. So we put a parenthesis 5 minus 3. Then it will add 4. Then it will add 2. Then it will subtract from the answer minus 1. Then you will add 7 to the answer. So the innermost parentheses are evaluated first. If you have all the precedence, all the operators having the same precedence level, then whichever comes first from left to right is the winner. So that's the way you can also perform the calculation of any arithmetic expression. So with this, we have concluded and completed the concepts that I wanted to discuss it in this lecture. Kindly go through all the slides, repeat these slides, listen carefully to the instructions, the explanations that I have provided, and I'm sure you should be able to learn all these concepts. With this, Allah Hafiz.